Now I am starting up with the 8th chapter of your book, which is Matrices. Matrices. Matrices to study about the numbers when they are arranged in the form of rows and columns. Now you know the horizontal lines are called the rows. And the vertical lines are called the columns. So when you arrange the numbers in the horizontal lines and the vertical lines, we call it as a matrix. And matrices is the plural of matrix. So in order to write any matrix, we always use the capital letters. Suppose if I write a matrix A and we are going to put the square brackets. You are going to write the numbers in the square brackets. Now I am writing one of the matrix for you. Suppose the matrix is 1, 2, 3, 0, minus 1, 4. Now see, I have arranged the numbers in rows and columns. As you can see, there are two horizontal lines which are called as rows. There are three vertical lines which are called as columns. So what do you say about the order? So order of the matrix will be 2 by 3. We read it as 2 by 3, where 2 is the number of rows and 3 is the number of columns. So rows are written first and then the columns. And these numbers 1, 2, 3, 0, minus 1, 4, they are known as the elements of the matrix A. And how many elements are there in this matrix? 2 multiply 3, that is, when you multiply the order 2 by 3, you get 6. So there are 6 elements in this matrix A. Now, we are going to study about the different type of matrices. Now the general formula for writing a matrix is, suppose there is a matrix A, the general formula for writing the matrix is A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23. In the same way, you can write more if you want more columns and more rows can be added. Now, A11 stands for the element of the first row, first column. A12 stands for the element of the first row, second column. A13 stands for the element of the first row, third column. Now, before starting up the exercise, let me tell you the difference of matrices which you will study. Now first is the row matrix. Suppose if I write a matrix P, row matrix. Row matrix is a matrix having only one row, but it can have as many columns as you want. So what is the order of this matrix P? It is 1 by 3. So it has got only one row. So this is called the row matrix. Now suppose if I take the matrix Q. Now instead of writing in the horizontal, I write it in the vertical form. Now you see there is only one column. What is the order? Order is 3 by 1. There is only one column. So such matrices which have got only one column, we call it as a column matrix. And the one having one row is called the row matrix. Now you have the rectangular matrix. Rectangular matrix is the one in which the number of rows and the number of columns are different. As I wrote in the beginning, 1, 2, 3, suppose 0, minus 1, 4. Suppose this is a matrix X. So what is the order of this matrix? There are two rows, two horizontal lines and three vertical lines. So order is 2 by 3. When the number of rows and number of columns are different, we call it as a rectangular matrix. And when the number of rows and the number of columns become same, as I have now written matrix X, it has got still two rows, but now the columns are also two. So the matrices which have the same number of rows and the same number of rows and columns, we call it as the square matrix. So it is of the order 2 by 2. You can have it of the order 3 by 3, 4 by 4 and so on. Now let us come with the identity matrix. Identity matrix, sometimes you may be asked to form the identity matrix yourself. Sometimes it is given in the question. But they will tell you the order. In order to form the identity matrix, we always use the square matrix. Identity matrix is made only of the square matrix, not the rectangular. Suppose if I ask you to make the identity matrix of order 2 by 2. In that, the diagonal elements will be 1 and rest of the elements will be 0. So this is the identity matrix of order 2 by 2 and we use letter I for it. So I is, if I ask you to form of order 3 by 3, the diagonal elements will be 1, 0, 0, then 0, 1, 0, then 0, 0, 1. These are called the diagonal elements. And the diagonal elements are the elements of A11, A22, A33. Diagonal elements are the elements of the first row, first column, second row, second column, third row, third column. These are the diagonal elements. The diagonal elements are taken as 1 and rest of the elements were to be written as 0. Now what is a zero matrix? By using this word zero only, you must have come to know that zero matrix, we denote it by O, and zero matrix has got all the elements as zero. It can be a rectangular, it can be a square matrix. As this is a zero matrix. So now I'm taking up the first question of your exercise. Now the first question says, classify the following matrices. So you can tell, first matrix you see is of the square matrix, second is the row matrix, like ways you can do it. Now I'm taking up the third question of your exercise 8.1. Third question says, construct a 2 by 2 matrix, means of the order 2 by 2, whose elements Aij. What do you mean by Aij? I stands for the row, J stands for the column. And the formula in order to find Aij is, I'm doing the first part, 2i minus j. This is the formula you have to use in order to make the matrix of order 2 by 2, where I stands for row and j stands for column. So first you are going to make A11 element. So in this, the value of I is 1. By comparing this, and the value of J is 1. Put their values in this formula given. So it will be 2 into 1 minus 1. What you get? 1. Now this is first row, first column. Now take first row, second column. Now the value of I is 1 and value of J is 2. I am substituting in this formula the value of I and J. Now the element of the first row and the second column is 0 because 2 minus 2 is 0. As it is a matrix of order 2 by 2, we are now going to take up the second row. Second row, first column. Second row, value of I is 2. Value of J is 1. So what is the element? 3. Now, in the same way, form the element of the second row, second column. Value of I is 2. And value of J is also 2. So, substituting again in this formula, value of I and J, you get it as 2. Now, you can form the matrix. You can write the matrix of order 2 by 2 and the elements are 1, 0, 3, 2. Arrange them in the matrix form. You can give any name to the matrix. A is equal to A11 is your 1, A12 is your 0, A21 is 3, A22 is 2. So this is how you have formed a matrix of order 2 by 2 by using the formula 2i minus j. Second part you will do yourself. Now 4 to 9th are of the same pattern. I am taking up the 8th question. When two matrices are given equal, then the corresponding elements will also be equal. Now in the 8th question, your matrix is x minus 2. Having the elements x minus 2, which is A11, A12 is Y, A21 is A plus 2B, and A22 is 3A minus B. This is given equal to 3, 1, 5, 1. These two matrices are given equal. So A11, as the matrices are equal, A11, yeah, that is x minus 2 is equal to 3. I told you the corresponding elements become equal, which implies that x is equals to 5. Now the question says to find the value of x, y, a and b. We have found the value of x. In the same way, you can find the value of y. Y is equal to 1. Then a plus 2b is equal to 5. And 3a minus b is equal to 1. Solve these equations simultaneously in order to get the value of, solve them simultaneously. Multiply the second equation by 2 and you are going to get the value. You know how to solve it. You are going to get the value of A and B also. So this is how you are going to find the value of X, Y, A and B. Now the complete exercise, you are going to do it yourself. In the next video, I'll tell you how to add the matrices and multiply them also.